guys, welcome back to San Antonio Living. Every month we're sharing stories of people who have changed their lives for the better or who are impacting others in a positive way. This month, thanks to our friends at La Fogata, we meet a man who has made a huge change in his life from running the streets to a professional boxer.
The boxing scene in San Antonio has boomed over the past several years. Kids and adults have not only become fans of the sport, but they are lacing up as well.
Before I even started boxing, I started running. I ran for like a month, every day, almost every day, Monday through Friday. I run like 3 or 4 miles. So when I go to the gym, I be in shape, you know. So the first gym I went to was Kelly Air Force Base, where the Air Force people train right here on Kelly. Then I went to San Fernando and started training. I was training myself, and I would get mitts from, you know, different people here and there. I'm just training myself, you know. And I was winning fights, you know what I mean? I was doing it on my own, you know, really, you know. And just training, nobody be like, you ran this and that, or you do this, or, you know, we're going to get this fight now. And I was fighting good people.
Meet boxer Benjamin Whitaker, who hopes to be the future champion in his own right. But his road to the ring has been full of many twists and turns. It all began back in college. Benjamin was a college student pursuing his degree, also trying to make ends meet.
I'm surprised I got out of middle school. But when I got to high school, I started playing basketball, you know, taking it serious. And that basketball really helped me pass my class, you know, make the grade so I could play, you know. You got to pass to play, so I did that. And then when I graduated, I got a little, you know, little scholarship to a junior college. Didn't know. I found out last minute I did get the scholarship, so I went there, Ranger College. I got involved in the wrong things, you know. And then after a while, you know, years went by, I never got caught. Then finally, you know, like every story ends like that. You either get caught, you go to jail, or you're dead, you know, one or the other. And that's true, you know. Not too many people make it out of a bad game like that, you know what I mean?
Instead of earning a degree, he scored a criminal record. Because of this, Benjamin went from the promise of endless possibilities to a reality of a limited career choice.
And it's hard to find a job, you know. After I got that felony, it was like, man, you go put an application and, yeah, we'll hire, you know. They look at you like that, and then when they do the background on you, they're like, oh, you know, they don't even call you and tell you, they send you a letter, you know. Oh, yeah, you know, according to your background, this and that. And it was I only been in trouble one time. I got in trouble when I was juvenile, you know, for minor stuff, you know what I mean? And that was just one time, you know.
It was through sports where Benjamin saw an opportunity to redeem his past and rewrite his future.
Well, I got in trouble, man, hustling, doing the wrong thing, and messed up opportunities to get a job, you know. So I just started boxing, man, and thinking, you know, I can make money at that and do the, and it's positive. It's not a negative thing, and it keep you out of trouble. So once I start boxing, the motivation, man, to win and train, it's dedication, you know, and it keep your mind occupied and don't keep you going off to the left, you know, do wrong things. It really changed my life, man.
Boxing promoter Rick Morones was the first to become interested in Benjamin's ambition and dedication to the sport.
I think I was at the Golden Gloves that I first got to really sit down and speak with Benjamin a bit. And he said, you know, it was in his mind to possibly, as soon as he turned pro, to come train with us. You know, being a trainer, you hear so many kinds of fighters say, I'm going to do this and this. And, you know, a lot of them don't ever do it, you know. So when he said that, you know, he ended up coming to the gym. He's been probably the hardest working fighter that I've ever trained. Probably would be the hardest working fighter I will ever get to train. You know, he's simply meant 100% when he's in the gym.
Benjamin has been training at Morona's Boxing Gym, well on his way to becoming the next boxing sensation, hoping to make most of his second chance.
And this is pretty much Benjamin's life now. You know, he took that lifestyle away that he was in, the trouble, and he used that as a tool to get in the gym and work hard, you know, and pursue a dream and a goal that he's trying to do, you know. And the good thing about Benjamin, he's also a good family person. He's a good father. He's a good husband, you know. And, you know, and that put together overall makes Benjamin a great person.
If you want to nominate someone to be featured in our Change Lives series, head over to our website at news4sanantonio.com and find the nomination form there. La Fogata is located on Vance Jackson Road. You can learn more by calling the number on your screen or just head over to lafogata.com, and we'll be right back.